size, speed, power, and complex learning abilities. These behaviors keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations around the world. We're excited to share their stories with you today. And you'll see the whales moving together in unison. These synchronized behaviors strengthen social bonds and enable them to problem solve as a group. Working together as a team is what makes them the ocean's top predator. Scientifically known as Orcinus orca, commonly referred to as killer whales, here at SeaWorld we know them as Katina, Milani, Malia, Trua, and Makaio, our killer whale family. Makaio is the youngest whale, and Katina is the oldest. She's his mother, and she this year celebrated her 47th birthday. Katina is also the matriarch or leader of our pod. SeaWorld's animal training techniques create a language between us and the whales. It's a language of love. Through positive reinforcement, encouragement, commitment, and care. Through these techniques and our relationships, the whales learn to trust us, and they even learn to take an active role in their very own health and well-being. Now here joining us in the slide-out area is our youngest whale, Makaio. And today is a very special day because today is Makaio's 13th birthday! To make each one very special with lots of love and toys. Now Makaio, even though he is 13 years old, he's almost 6,000 pounds and he's still growing. What he's demonstrating right now is actually how we weigh our whales. So we weigh them by asking them to slide their bodies up and out of the water and onto a killer whale size scale located in one of our adjacent pools. You'll notice that a portion of his body from his dorsal fin to his tail flips is still in the water. This is the powerhouse of the killer whale. It's called the peduncle, and it's very heavy and very muscular. With the peduncle still in the water, we would not be getting an accurate weight, so we're able to solve that problem by simply asking them to lift their tails up and out of the water. Training this posture enables us to ensure accuracy, so we know that the younger whales, like Makaio, are growing properly, and the older whales are retaining a healthy weight.
Isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital. We surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. For the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Did you know that killer whales love to play? They actually learn a lot by playing and through mimicry and observational learning. From a young age, killer whales learn important life skills by playing games such as follow the leader with their mother and other whales. And we're going to put that to the test today with birthday boy Makaio in this intersection of the stadium. So go ahead and stand up. We're going to play a game of killer whale follow the leader. You will be the leader and Makaio will follow. So on the count of three, you'll spin in a circle two times. Ready? One, two, three, spin. Let me see it. Let's give him a great big cheer. All right, right side of the stadium, it's your turn. So stand up. We have an even bigger jump plan. This is called a breach. So on the count of three, you'll take your left hand, bring it to the side of your leg and out to the sky. Ready? One, two, three. Give that signal. And Drew is off. Killer whales will breach for a number of different reasons. Whether to surprise their prey, scratch an itch, or just to get a better look around. But more often than not, killer whales will breach just to show off. So here comes Trua, showing off his breach in 3, 2, 1! In the ocean, Unfortunately, overfishing, pollution, and other factors are having a serious impact on some killer whale populations.
One ripple that can grow and grow
and change.
Together, we've got this.